Welcome to Shree Learning Academy. Our today's topic is replay attack. So let's get started. Introduction to replay attacks. To understand cybersecurity, we must delve into the types of threats that exist in the digital world. One of the most prevalent and dangerous cyber threats is known as the replay attack. To put it in simple terms, a replay attack occurs when a malicious actor intercepts a data transmission and retransmits it. It's a bit like recording someone's conversation and then playing it back to pretend that you're them. This type of attack is primarily focused on data packets related to authentication, with the aim to trick the system into granting unauthorized access. The essence of replay attacks. In a replay attack, the perpetrator doesn't directly steal the victim's credentials. Instead, they cunningly capture and resend packets containing those credentials. Think of these packets as sealed letters that you are sending to a friend, which contain important private information. Now imagine a person who steals these letters, not to open and read them, but to send them again to your friend. In doing so, they trick your friend into thinking that the letters are fresh ones from you. Essentially, this is what happens in a replay attack. The attacker captures these data packets, or letters, and resends them, causing the receiving system to believe that they are legitimate. While replay attacks can theoretically target any data packet, the ones containing authentication information are the most attractive. These packets are like digital keys that unlock access to various parts of a network or system. By reusing these keys, the attacker can gain unauthorized entry. The main targets, legacy systems. It's important to note that replay attacks are particularly effective against what are known as legacy systems. These are older, often outdated systems that are still in use, typically due to cost or complexity associated with upgrading. Since these systems were designed and built before modern cyber threats emerged, they lack the necessary defenses to fend off attacks like replay attacks. To illustrate this, let's consider a legacy system that uses simple password-based authentication. In such a system, whenever a user logs in, their username and password are sent as a packet over the network. An attacker can capture this packet and replay it later to gain access. This is a classic replay attack scenario and one that many legacy systems are vulnerable to. Modern authentication and its defenses. Luckily, most modern systems have implemented defenses to combat replay attacks. While the concept of a replay attack is simple, defending against it can be complex and requires a multifaceted approach. Limited validity through timestamps. One method is to include timestamps in the authentication packets. Much like a ticket for a concert or sports event is only valid for a specific time and date, these timestamps ensure that the authentication packet can only be used within a certain time frame. If an attacker captures and attempts to resend this packet after the timestamp has expired, the system will reject it. For example, let's assume you log into a secure system that implements timestamps. The timestamp might be valid for only a few minutes. An attacker intercepting this packet would then have only a small window to perform their replay attack. If they try to use it later, the system will see that the timestamp is out of date and deny access. Challenge response dialogs. Another technique involves using random challenge response dialogs. In this system, when a user tries to authenticate, the server sends a unique challenge. The user's system must then respond correctly to this challenge to gain access. Since the challenges are random and used only once, a replay attack would fail because the captured response wouldn't match a new challenge from the server. Think of this as a secret handshake. Each time you meet a friend, you create a new handshake. If someone tries to mimic the handshake later, it won't work because you've already changed it. Ephemeral session encryption keys. A third method involves the use of ephemeral session encryption keys. These are encryption keys generated for each session, and they're discarded once the session is over. If an attacker captures a packet and tries to replay it in a new session, it won't work because the encryption key from the previous session is no longer valid. Imagine you have a lock that changes its key every time you unlock it. Even if someone steals your key, they can't use it again because the lock's mechanism has already changed for the next use. Conclusion. Replay attacks present a real threat to both legacy and unprepared modern systems. They hinge on the clever idea of not stealing the credentials, but resending the captured packets containing them to gain unauthorized access. Legacy systems, with their outdated defenses, are particularly vulnerable to such attacks. But as we've seen, modern systems employ various sophisticated defenses against replay attacks. from using timestamps for limited validity of packets, random challenge response dialogs, to ephemeral session encryption keys, these techniques help secure systems from these cyber threats. By understanding these methods, we can appreciate the importance of ongoing developments in cybersecurity, emphasizing the need for continual updates and improvements to our digital systems. As our world becomes more interconnected, the importance of understanding and combating threats like replay attacks will only grow. Therefore, learning about them, the damage they can inflict, and how we can protect our systems is not just essential for IT professionals, but also for anyone who uses digital services. In the end, replay attacks teach us a valuable lesson. In the digital world, staying ahead of potential threats is not just about having the right keys, but knowing how and when to change the locks. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do check out the written explanation on our website and don't forget to take this quiz based on this video. The links are in the description box below. Subscribe to our channel to watch more interesting videos. If you have any doubts, do let us know in the comment section and we will try our best to solve them for you. For private coaching, do contact us by visiting shreelearningacademy.com or on WhatsApp. See you in the next one.